My journey began more than 4 years ago when I got to the point where I had to address my pain because of scoliosis. I had my first surgery, and while I had the relief of pain for a while, that journey continued. The pain got worse and worse and got to the point where I knew I have to do something about it. In order to address my scoliosis and give me relief from pain, I have to have major back surgery so I can focus on getting better, learning to be me again, pain-free, learning to get back to the things in life that I love, including being here.
Right now, because of the scoliosis, your nerves are severely compressed. So that's the number one goal, even before correcting the scoliosis.
This small gray dot here is a nerve coming out of the spine.
And there's a lot of disability coming from the leg pain, the prolonged standing, that eventually will slowly take you to a point that you won't be able to stand up or walk. And that's what we are trying to do. It's not only put your spine straight in common terms, but also to prevent this from getting worse.
That takes me out of life for a while. It will take me out of television for 2 to 3 months. I've been down this road before, and I know the pain that's to come and how it has to be controlled with opioids. That's frightening when I see what's happening here and in my city and my state and in the nation. I want to be very aware that while it's a wonderful tool, this medicine is serious. It has to be managed. And I'm looking for other ways to help deal with that pain.
We are in the process of doing research on opioid addiction. And myself included, we are elaborating on a randomized controlled trial to try new non-opioid drugs after surgery to reduce the use of opioids. We manage this in a comprehensive way. So we have an interventional pain management team that immediately assess you after surgery and interview you after surgery, and we start a very aggressive treatment of pain after surgery. That will include not only IV medications or pain pills, but actually direct medication into the surgery area. So we have direct catheters that infuse non-opioid, numbing medicine to your skin constantly right after surgery for 48 hours.
Internally. So this decision and this step has opened my eyes to an opportunity now to share it with you. Maybe shine a light on the good things that are happening and the advances made in medicine.
We have a significant change in that since 4 years ago. Number one, I'm here. I'm bringing a lot of new technology to the institution, new approaches and new literature on advances in spine care that have been able to complement what we had here already. At the end of the day, that when I ask you, like I do all of my patients, when I see them in 6 weeks, was it worth it? That the response is yes.
And it helps me cope with this very big, tough journey that continues by putting it in the context of my life and my career. Dealing with chronic pain can change a person. It's changed me. So this journey through pain is also a journey back. I think I'll be a better mom. I know I'll be a better mom, a nicer friend, and hopefully I'll be better for you too. But I'm not going anywhere. You can still see me. You can still hear about my journey back through Facebook, through Twitter, through email. It gives me that focus to continue to connect with who I am and with the folks out there who've been so good to me and are genuinely concerned about me. It helps me to open up about this because it's such a huge part of who I am. This journey has taken a lot out of me, but it's given me a lot back.